The COVID-19 pandemic continues to take a significant toll on the lives of many Manitobans, and I know that Winnipeggers continue to appreciate the efforts of the province of Manitoba and Shared Health to mitigate the impact and spread of COVID-19 in our community. Life as we know it has changed, but I know that Winnipeggers can weather any storm. As we continue to deliver essential services to our residents during the pandemic, the financial impacts on our municipality continue to grow. As an example, Winnipeg transit ridership levels are down by about 70%. Our recreation centers and libraries remain closed, and revenue from other fees have dropped significantly. The city has closed many of its public facilities in order to support provincial public health orders to maintain appropriate physical distancing. We're utilizing our 311 call center to support provincial enforcement in our community. And while the city supports these measures, the impact on the city's finances is significant and growing. As many of you know, the city's most recent projections indicated that we're losing about $12 million per month as a result of the measures put in place to comply with the provincially mandated physical distancing measures. A recent report to our Standing Policy Committee of Finance projects that with the pandemic measures in place or remaining in place until the end of August, the city will lose about $78 million. The city's managing its expenses by implementing several measures, such as temporarily laying off about 9% of its total workforce, including 672 non-permanent staff, 246 full and part-time Winnipeg transit operators, reducing weekday transit service, and reducing discretionary expenses across departments. I should note, however, that the city's four-year balanced operating budget, which provides a recently replenished financial stabilization reserve, and the expenditure reduction measures are expected at this time to enable the city to temporarily withstand the financial impact of the pandemic, provided the provincially mandated physical distancing measures don't extend beyond August. However, the current financial situation stemming from the pandemic highlights very clearly the city's antiquated revenue model and warrants immediate action between the province and the city on a modern growth-oriented funding framework. As a result, today I'm proposing a renewed partnership between the province and the city to immediately develop and implement a post-pandemic plan for economic recovery through the following five measures. One, maintain existing levels of capital and operating support for the city this year and commit to maintain these funding levels for the remaining 3 years of the city's multi-year balanced budgets. Two, accelerate payment of the provincial capital and operating support to the city this year and provide the city with full discretion on how to invest these funds in support of council-approved priorities. Three, immediately and fully support and forward the City Council-endorsed application for federal and provincial cost-sharing of $643.4 million under the Investment in Canada Infrastructure Program to support the renewal and upgrade of the North End Sewage Treatment Plant, construction of a new recreation centre in Southwest Winnipeg, and an expansion of the St. James Civic Centre. Four, commit to partnering with the city to maximize the city's share of existing available federal transit funding under the ICIP program, with specific investments to be guided by the soon-to-be-completed and released Transit Master Plan. And lastly, for the City of Winnipeg to recover and support economic growth, commit to implement a modern growth-oriented funding framework. We need to put in place a post-pandemic recovery plan that protects essential services and provides for the necessary investments to maintain a strong economy for Winnipeg and the province. We are better together. Let's demonstrate that. As always, I remain committed to working collaboratively with the province while also defending the interests of all Winnipeggers who call this city home.